Labor's whipped out the abacus and they don't like what it's telling them.
If you're a Labor MP or a Liberal MP or a Nat, you get 4 staff. If you're a Green or if you're a Crossbench MP, you get 8.
Can you count, suckers?
That seems to me to be a bit out of whack.
If you can count.
So they plan to cut Crossbench's staff allocation back from 4 advisors to just 1 while maintaining their 4 electorate staff, effectively winding the clock back to 2010.
I recall, I think it was 2010 with the hung parliament where then Prime Minister Julia Gillard gave the Crossbench an additional staff member. Malcolm Turnbull increased that to 3, and Scott Morrison, as Prime Minister, increased it to 4.
Independents are hopping mad. Without the institutional muscle of the major parties, they reckon they need that extra help to scrutinise legislation, work through amendments, meet stakeholders, etc.
It's basically saying I don't respect the work the Crossbench has done in the last parliament or can do in this coming parliament.
But the government is unmoved.
Everybody's taken a haircut here, whether it's government staff, opposition staff, most Australians would say, well, you've been elected, now knuckle down and do the job.
So what does Peter Dutton think about it all? Well, either the opposition leader's indifference alarm is going off, or the beat's about to drop, or both.
It's a very loud beat. Well, that's an issue for the government.
But regardless of the rights or wrongs, it could be a bit of a blunder from the new government. Labor will need 13 votes from the Senate crossbench to pass any of its legislation. And they've just cheesed off the lot of them.
This is not a cost-saving exercise. This is a political decision.
Jackie Lambie has pulled out her signature move, fuming, while One Nation's threatened to oppose all government legislation as a default position. So, has the new government just potted a stunning own goal, or is it simply levelling the playing field?
Newly minted independent ACT Senator David Pocock joins us now. David, what's your reaction to the decision?
Great to be with you all. Pretty surprised, disappointed. Not the start I was hoping for. And, you know, this is not me being dudded. This is the people that I'm in there to represent. The ACT has 2 senators. We've got almost the same population as Tassie, who have 12. So it's really important that I have adequate staff to actually do my job and represent the people who want me voting on their behalf.
Can we just talk about the raw numbers, though? Because the scenario is such that actually independents end up with more staff than some government members, some opposition members as well. Why do you actually need more than what they have to be able to do this job?
The thing that's not being talked about is that the government has over 480 personal staff and then also access to the public service. You know, the Prime Minister has 6 people just doing media in his office. So if you talk about, you know, personal parliamentary staff for independence, it's crucial that we have advisors that can actually, you know, be reading through legislation, then be consulting and helping inform the way that we vote.
Do you understand why, you know, for the public just probably never having thought about this issue particularly before, it seems pretty wild that an independent needs their electorate office staff plus another 4 staff just to be able to turn up and do the job?
Yeah, and the really cynical take is that the PM knows that. He knows that people have very little sympathy for politicians and their staff, and so he's using this as a way to actually, you know, minimise how effective independents will be in being able to represent the people that in there to represent. I guess, to me, the conversation should be about how do we want the people who are actually making the big decisions that affect every part of our life to be resourced. You know, if you look at something like the Jenkins Review, there were a number of submissions in there talking about just how stretched and overworked staff were. So I would really love to see this as part of a bigger conversation and potentially, you know, take it away from just the whims of the Prime Minister.
David, what I'm curious about is that there's apparently a lot of Parliament sports teams, I'm told, including rowing and footy. Are you getting a lot of calls from people wanting you to join their team? And isn't this an opportunity to go up against people you disagree with and literally smash them physically?
Yeah, we'll see. I'd love to get involved. I think there is a pretty big rugby team. I don't think you end up getting a lot of minutes each. There's that many people wanting to play.
I'm really looking forward to the news footage of Barnaby Joyce and David Pocock.
I think it's going to be the first assassination by rugby that we see in Australian political history.
Well, we could make a great open side and blind side. Who knows?
Well, Senator Pocock, thanks so much for chatting to us.
Thanks for having me on. Cheers.